interested in using voice control and a home automation system to assist people with disabilities. Today we're going to help one of my regular viewers construct a practical solution to improve his everyday living. This is also a great setup for those living in small apartments such as studios and rentals. So, stay tuned. Hi again, John Stone, the DIY Smart Home Guy. In a previous video, I discussed the need for a voice assistant in your smart home. I made mention in that video of how smart home usage is on the rise to help persons with disabilities and also people that have accessibility issues. I recently received a message from Bob asking for help. Hi, Mr. Snow, and I love the Game of Thrones reference.
You know nothing, John Snow.
I'm a quadriplegic, I have received an Echo Dot 2, so I've been looking for online things controlled by my voice, SmartThings. I have two on-off wall switches and a smart TV, Samsung. I can use a laptop, but that's it. What do you suggest I use? So to help Bob out, we're going to discuss a solution that is both cost-effective and workable for several scenarios that Bob could face on an everyday basis. This solution could help anyone that relies on a wheelchair or faces limited mobility on a daily basis. If you watched my last video, you'll remember that I stressed the importance of two things when putting together a smart home. One is focusing on the usability of the system that you create, and the second is having a plan that considers how the home will be controlled when and if the automation aspects fail. When planning home automation, it's all about how the people will access the system, disabled or not. The primary purpose of the configuration I'm about to describe is to use Bob's new Echo Dot to allow him to control his lights and television. But what happens if the Echo goes offline? Bob is going to need to revert to a control mechanism that isn't solely relying on voice. Bob also mentioned that he can use a laptop. So, the ideal configuration will allow him to use his laptop as an alternate form of control. This can be a big challenge since most hubs require a smartphone, and those that run on a PC are somewhat complex. And if the internet or hub goes offline, say for an update or something, the solution will need to revert to manual control, which should mimic exactly what he uses today. Oh yeah, and it also needs to be able to control his TV. So let's get into the solution. The system will consist of the following components: a Samsung SmartThings Hub 2.0, two GE in-wall smart switches to control the lighting and the fan, the Amazon Echo Dot 2 for the overall system control. You could just as easily use a Google Home in this setup, but since Bob already has the Amazon Alexa, we'll go with that in this video. We'll also be bringing in a Logitech Harmony Hub to control the TV. And one additional thing that we'll bring in is not hardware, but it's actually software, and it's called SmartTiles. This is a very nice PC interface into the SmartThings Hub. I selected the SmartThings Hub in this scenario specifically because of the SmartTiles interface and the fact that it will allow Bob to control a smart home from his laptop. At this time, there really isn't a good alternative on the Wink Hub side that allows PC access. So if the Amazon Echo Dot does go offline, he can easily revert to controlling his home from his notebook. I chose the GE switches specifically because they operate like a normal switch in terms of use. Up is on and down is off. Other switches can be used, and Bob, you should feel free to substitute a different set of switches as long as they're compatible with the SmartThings Hub. I've left the link to the video that installs these switches in the description below. And the first thing to do will be to get those switches installed. Now that we have that out of the way, let's get the switches connected into the hub. For that, we'll go to the lab and set them up. Okay, so in the lab, I've got these switches right here. We're gonna go ahead and connect those into the SmartThings app. So you're gonna have to do this with a smartphone. This part, there's no way to avoid this, but you'll need a smartphone to do this initial setup, and then we'll bring it over to the SmartTiles app. So down in the bottom of the screen, you'll see these four little squares. We're gonna tap on those, and this is where we're gonna go in and add our thing. So we're going to click Add Thing. It's going to say looking for devices, and then it's pretty much as simple as we're just going to turn that on, and it should take just a couple seconds and it's going to recognize that device. If you get worried that it's taking a little bit too long, just turn it off, turn it on, and you should see that device come straight in. There it is. Okay, so turn that light off so we're not blinding you. Now from here, well, let's just go in and do the rename device real quick. And since this is my lab, we're just gonna say lab light. And we're done. Save that. We've successfully paired one device. And now that lab light is set up in the SmartThings app. So that's going to be pretty simple. All right, the switches are installed and connected into the SmartThings hub. Next, let's get these connected into the Echo. There's a link to the Amazon Echo setup in the description below, so no need to do that here. The only difference between that video and this setup is that you'll need to connect the SmartThings skill instead of the Wink skill. Easy enough, right? Getting the Echo to recognize the switches is as simple as saying, Alexa, discover devices.
Starting discovery. Discovery is complete. I found 78 smart home devices.
Now it's time to get this set up in the SmartTiles app. The application can be found at www.smarttiles.click. You'll need your SmartThings login to continue here.
All right, so from the website, we're going to go to install. And then there's the install now. Now, if you would like to get emails from them, you can put your email address in here. If not, just click go. And then that's going to take you to an authorization screen. Now there is a login screen in the middle of this. Just enter your username and password for the SmartThings app. That'll take you to this authorization screen. And then we're going to say authorize home. And then we click authorize.
Okay, now we're going back into the SmartThings app on the smartphone. And if you see down on the bottom of the screen here, you're going to have this middle button with the little check mark in the circle. And if you come over to that Smart Apps tab, you'll come down there and you'll see SmartTiles Connect. If that's not there, you're going to want to add that in. Use the plus and add that in, and it'll bring it. So from there, you're going to need to create a dashboard. If you scroll down in the app, you'll have these five sections here. When you click on that, you can come in here, you can name the dashboard, set it up. Okay, so to get to this from our computer, there's one last piece that we're going to have to do. If we go into that dashboard and we scroll down to the bottom of the list, you'll see a view dashboard and URL. Click on that. And you can either preview or browse that dashboard to see what that's going to look like. So let's take a look at that real quick. There's my lab light. Click that on, click that off. Done with that. Now the one that we're going to want is the Git Launcher URL. So by doing that Git Launcher URL, that's going to give me the URL right there. Now you're going to need to copy this and send it to yourself over on your laptop, and we'll get that over the laptop, and then we'll show it on the laptop side.
Okay, so come back over into your browser and you'll paste in that link that you sent yourself, and you should be faced with this thing that says launch. And we'll launch into that. We'll have to authenticate one more time. And then you have your routines, your lab light, anything you want over here. So I should just be able to click that and it'll turn on my lab light. And there we go. So now SmartTiles is all set up.
All right, now we have voice control over the ceiling fan and the light, backup control via the laptop, and manual reversion that requires no change in behavior. Easy enough, right? Now the last piece is getting the Logitech Harmony Hub connected into the system as well. To me, this is the coolest piece. I can't even begin to imagine what life is like with a severe disability, but I can't imagine that channel surfing has got to be a major pain. Having voice control over the TV will be liberating. For setup, there are two options. You can use a smartphone, or you can use a PC / laptop. To help Bob out, we're going to use the laptop setup. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is you're going to go over to the My Harmony webpage, myharmony.com/hub. Okay, so once we're on this page, we're going to want to scroll all the way to the bottom of this page until we get past all of the mobile device apps, and we're going to go to the very bottom and do download. And we have the Harmony Hub, so we're just going to do the Harmony Hub software and then download the software. And that should get it on your desktop. All right, okay, we're just going to let this load up, get the welcome to the My Harmony. Now, once you have this on your desktop, you're going to need to create an account. I already have an account, so we're going to skip over that, but it's not that difficult to do. Typical stuff, you're going to need an email address and a password. So at this point, you're going to want to plug the USB cable into the Harmony Hub and then plug that into your laptop. And you'll need to add this device. Once the device is added, then you're just going to come in here and you'll set up your devices. Now this is where you're going to set up your TV. You're going to click on this add device, add your TV in.
After you get your television set up, go over to the Activities tab. And this is where you can program in different activities. All right. Last but not least, you're going to want to come in here and select a TV service provider. Now, if you're on cable or whether you're off air, you're just going to put in your zip code and you're going to set up your service provider information. And then after that, you're going to edit your favorite channels. Now, these channels here, it's important that you set these up. Whatever you put the star next to, this is what's going to be available inside your Echo. Okay, so you've set up the Harmony, you've added in your devices, and then you've added in your favorite channels. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to go over to the Alexa app, and that's where we're going to add in the skills, and we're almost done.
Once you have that all set up, get the Alexa skills, both of them. There's two skills for the Logitech Harmony Hub, one for smart home integration and one for general TV control. All right, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go into the Alexa app and we're going to get two different skills. Both of them are for the Harmony Hub. So let's go in and do that right now. In the Alexa app, you're going to do skills. Now under skills, you're going to want to search for Harmony. And you're going to see these two skills right here. One of them is optimized for smart home and the other one is just a regular Logitech Harmony skill. Let's go ahead and add both of those in. So I already have them enabled, but you're going to want the blue one and you're going to want the red one. Now when you go into your smart home on the Amazon Echo, you're only going to see one of those skills enabled and that'll be the blue skill. This is going to allow you to bypass anything like saying, Alexa, tell Harmony. You can just go straight in and say, Alexa, turn television on. We're going to go do that in just a minute. But I just wanted to come down here and show you what's happening here. You'll see that you've got a bunch of new commands down here like TV, HBO, where you see these HBO, cable news, sci-fi, Food Network, Home and Garden, History Channel, HBO2. All of those are the favorite channels that we set up over there in the Harmony Hub app, and that's what linked them over here. So just a second, we're going to go down and we're going to run a few test commands and then we'll be wrapping this up. After you get these set up, run Discover Devices once again. Okay, so the last thing I want to do is talk about what the difference is between the blue app and the red app here. So the blue app, this is the smart home app. What this is going to allow you to do is use those trigger words. You see the trigger words in the smart home section of the Alexa app, then you can use that as a trigger word. So you can do anything like say turn on the TV, turn off the TV, or you can just simply say Alexa turn on Home and Garden and it'll turn on that favorite channel from Home and Garden. But you also have extended activities that you can do here, and this is through the red app that we installed or the red skill that we installed, and this is where you can say Alexa tell Harmony to pause, tell Harmony volume up, tell Harmony volume down. But you have additional skills here that you have, but you have to use the Tell Harmony command to do this. But anything you see over on that smart home list, that you can go straight into and you do not have to say Tell Harmony. So that's pretty cool. Okay, so as you can see, we have that Harmony Hub sitting down on the bottom of the end table between the two couches. And that is, with everything we have connected together, going to allow me to just use simple commands to turn the TV on. Alexa, turn on Home and Garden.
Okay.
Now you can see right here, we've got the little white light coming on. This is going to take just a couple seconds for the TV to fire up, but you see the TV starting to come on, and this is actually going to change the channel directly to Home and Garden television. Alexa, tell Harmony to mute television.
Okay.
So that time we used the Tell Harmony command, but you can see that it muted the television. Alexa, tell Harmony channel up.
Okay.
So we can either use the favorite channels that we pre-programmed or we can use the channel up, channel down. This makes channel surfing a breeze. Alexa, tell Harmony to unmute the TV.
Okay.
And there you go. So now we have full control through voice, Alexa, using the Harmony Hub, and we've got full control over the television. Alexa, turn television off.
Okay.
There you have it. Home automation with voice control is a huge step forward for those in assisted living situations. When properly implemented, smart home tech is a great way to improve quality of life for everyone and it can be installed for a relatively low cost, and that's pretty cool. But you've got to admit, this is a cool setup, even if you're not disabled.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to click like. Over here are a couple of other videos that you might enjoy. For more reviews, tips, and DIY videos, visit azhb.com. And thanks to all of you that already follow me over on Facebook or Twitter. Both are at DIY Smart Home Guy. Until next time, cheers.